prison sex. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for some prison sex with Tool. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Tool Undertow Prison Sex Reaction and Understanding and Deep Dive and whatever, where I try to figure out what the heck is going on in a Tool song. It's been a fantastic series. I've been loving making these Tool videos, and here is another one for you. I'm Mr. Rapid K-Mate, and I do reactions every single day here on my channel. So if you like that, hit like, subscribe today for the reactions every day, and head over to Patreon, where I do full unedited reactions to TV, anime, movies, documentaries, and more every single day. I think next week we're going to be doing 11 uploads on Patreon. It's insane, and I appreciate the support from all my wonderful patrons right down here. Thank you so much. But yeah, last one we did was we did Tool Intolerance. We did Intolerance, and that was, I had to Google it. I had no idea. I had no idea what the meaning was, and you know what? I wanted to, but I just didn't. And I found such wonderful insight, and you guys in the comment section really let me know and help me out as well. And that's what I love. We have this dialogue where we work together to unfold the mysteries that Maynard leaves behind for us in Tool. Prison sex. The fuck? Hey! I've also been told the song isn't about having sex in prison. Okay, so, well, this sounds like he's struggling. He's been in a struggle through his life. Like, it took so long to remember what happened. But I'm breathing, so I guess I'm still alive, even if signs seem to tell me otherwise. And my head down and my eyes closed. My throat's wide open. Do unto others what has been done to me. Do unto others what has been done to you. Is this, I know, I was told this isn't about prison sex. So that's my first window into the mind of Maynard. And I know that this whole album is supposed to be like about addiction and dealing with addiction and things like that. Could this be him? He's gone through a trauma, some kind of trauma. Maybe it's drugs. Maybe it's something else. And he's dealing with it. He's trying to cope with that. I mean, he says later on, he says, I guess I'm still alive, even if signs tell me otherwise. After he says that, I need to sleep a while. He's tired. He said he was treading water too. I noticed that. So maybe he's just feeling like he's in a funk. He's not going anywhere. He's like, oh man, I'm just so tired of this. I am so into the guitar in this and the drums. Like, it's always good, but like this one was like, and then when it just, like it just came in. It was great. It's fantastic. Now, I don't know what this stuff at the beginning was. It kind of sounds like someone's like ripping a floorboard up, or I thought at first it was a chainsaw, but like it kind of just sounds like something being torn. And beaten. Something broken. His youth, he has trouble remembering. He was so young. Maybe he was abused. I know he went to like a military school. We learned that in the last one. Drugs. Only this one medium brings me peace of mind. Boom. Booyaka. There it is. Maybe it's about how drugs take a hold of you and you just feel like you're just caught in this cycle. Whoa. Is that a bass? Instrumentalist fire! Woo! Ooh. That instrumental was fire. Oh my god, that bass. Blood and cum on my hands. That's an image, isn't it? Some kind of temporary sadness. Blood on my hands. I'm cold. I really enjoyed that. I love the instrumental. I love the way it slowed down there in the end. And just kind of, it kind of sounded like someone who was just getting high and someone's getting like kind of like just drifting off. But I also love the, he looks so precious. He's talking to the drugs. This will be over soon. He, you know, it feels to me like he's talking about drugs and his struggle with drugs, but also how they help him get it through trauma that he's had in his past. And, you know, I think I found some kind of temporary sanity in this. I don't know how that's not drugs. I really think that, I mean, obviously they talk about sex in the song, but it definitely seems to me like someone is using drugs to get over, or maybe they're in like a, they find like a an escape happy place to get out of some kind of trauma that happened when they were young. It sounds like abuse to me. It could be abuse, it could be drugs, it could be anything, but they found, you know, it seems to me like it's about abuse. And it could be abuse of drugs again, but also they found this kind of way to deal with their trauma and their pain. And I think as well, like, there's a lot of repetition and a lot of emptiness. Excuse me. In terms of singing, there's these instrumental breaks, and they are fantastic, but I think they're more than just that. Like, for one sweet moment, I am whole, and then there's no words. Oops, I meant, so you, there was, but you look so precious now, and then nothing, like, that seems like, they could either say, be talking to, like, the drugs, or, like, you look so precious now, maybe that's something about the abuse, I don't know, but it definitely, like, there's some elements here that really are elements to a picture that I haven't fully formulated. Like, again, this intro has to mean something. Like, it sounds like, it almost sounds like someone knocking, but then it also sounds like floorboards being ripped up. It's like, maybe it's about like breaking in and abusing someone. I don't know, but it's a very interesting song. Very interesting. There's a lot of like invasive language, a lot of words that kind of just feel like they make you uncomfortable. Like, close enough so I can smell you. Like, who says that? That's not something that you say to, you know, in a normal conversation or to make someone feel at ease, you know? So I think this definitely has something to do with abuse. And that's about as far as I go. But, like, dealing and struggling with that abuse, like, the struggle to deal with abuse and how you deal with abuse, maybe that's what the song's about. Found some kind of temporary sanity in this. And then there's cum. Blood and cum on my hands. That could be like a really, that could be abuse as well. Like, I don't know, why is there blood and cum in your hands? I don't think that's like a normal thing. It's not like a happy, oh God, oh, just another Thursday night with blood and cum on my hands, you know? So let me know in the comment section below what you think. And if I go anywhere near being correct on this one, I'm trying. I'm trying to get myself into the mindset of Maynard, but obviously there's a lot there. There's a lot to digest. So thank you so much for joining me for this video. I enjoyed this song a lot. I really, really love the instrumentals in this. The instrumentals in this one were a huge highlight for me on this song. Like this video, subscribe today for reactions every single day. And if you'd like even more content and to support me, you can head over to Patreon and you can do a subscription there and get full unedited reactions to TV, anime, movies, documentaries, and more. Full and unedited, only on Patreon. Have a great night. Check out some of these videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.